Lai Wei Jie, Singapore, 2033. Lai Wei Jie is standing on the Esplanade Bridge, peering out at the water that sparkles beneath the first rays of the morning sun. He can feel the familiar vibrations of the city waking up, subtly resonating beneath his feet, blending harmoniously with the rhythmic lapping of the water against the pillars. Lai allows his gaze to sweep the cityscape, the magnificent mix of traditional and modern, familiar yet ever-evolving. It's 2033, and Singapore breathes an air of distinct singularity, a unique fusion of culture and technology that has evolved over the years. Lai sets off on his daily bike toward the university, feeling the refreshing breeze against his skin. He passes the Marina Bay Sands, where interactive AER displays seamlessly blend with the breathtaking architectural design. It's a symbolic juxtaposition, the testament to Singapore's leap into the future while remaining rooted in its rich past. Arriving at the university, Lee's greeted by the bright, eager eyes of his students, some dialing in virtually from halfway across the globe. Today, they are discussing the Emotigate scandal and the subsequent introduction of the Emotional Data Rights Law. It's a significant part of their curriculum and essential lesson about ethical boundaries in technology. The lecture flows smoothly, punctuated by lively discussions and debates. After class, Lai goes to the local kopitiam for lunch. The smell of fresh kaya toast and kopio wafts through the air, carrying years of nostalgia for him. As he savors his lunch, he enjoys overhearing passionate discussions about privacy, emotional autonomy, and technology at neighboring tables. Afternoons are usually spent in his office, working on research or advising students. Today, he's working on an AER project to use emotion recognition technology to identify student stress patterns and provide personalized support. It's a challenge, but Lai finds the process fulfilling, knowing the positive impact it could make. After his working session, Lee winds down with a stroll around the city, savoring the sights and sounds around him. He notices a family huddled together at Merlion Park, a group of young artists sketching at Clark Quay, and a street performer entertaining a growing crowd with his vibrant music. Everywhere Lai looks, he sees an ER subtly enhancing experiences while preserving the essence of the Lion City. Dinner is a simple affair at home. Lai enjoys cooking and finds it therapeutic, and he's making Hainanese chicken rice tonight. The rich, aromatic smells fill his apartment, mingling with the sunset view from his window, creating a distinctly home ambience. His wrist watch vibrates, and Lai knows the vibration pattern. He reached a relaxing state of his body, a good sign that he managed his day successfully. As Lai heads to bed, he feels a sense of satisfaction at the end of the day. As a part of this city, he sees himself as a conduit between tradition and progress. In the heart of this bustling city-state, he is an educator, a researcher, a brother, and a citizen living, shaping, and witnessing the unfolding of Singapore's unique narrative.